Subscribe to Lab X and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any episodes of Chemist in the Kitchen.
We have our really, really cute goldfish cracker cookie cutters.
Nope.
Ah, they're so cute.
This is definitely a little bit more work than I was expecting it to be.
Maybe we should have picked Cheez-Its. Those you just have to cut into squares.
Hello, and welcome back to Chemists in the Kitchen. Today, we're going to be recreating a favorite snack, which is goldfish.
The snack that smiles back.
Goldfish.
I am Julie Pollock, and I am an associate professor of biochemistry at the University of Richmond.
Hi, I'm Joan Walker, and I am a conservation scientist in Washington, D.C.
I'm Daisy Rosas Vargas, and I am a science communicator and educator based in Southern California.
I was interested in, is there some like sort of science behind the fact that a lot of people like crunchy snacks? Some of it is really related to texture. So people like food that have multiple types of texture because it keeps your brain engaged while you're eating. That sort of crunchiness comes with a sense of freshness. And so it associates the crunchiness with freshness, which I think actually you can associate a lot of times with vegetables, a lot of vegetables or even some fruits that are crunchy as well.
Like if you bite into like a romaine lettuce and it's crunchy, you know it's good. But if it's like spoiled, it's not gonna have that crunch. So maybe it was like meant for like, hey, we shouldn't eat this, it's not good for us.
We've all had the experience of, you know, having a stale cracker. Yeah. And it's just like the worst. It's just, you know, it's like you're anticipating this cracker and then it's kind of like, eh. It just doesn't have that snap to it, right? And so like, even though the flavor profile is probably not that different, but it lacks that texture that you really want.
So our recipe today is pretty simple. It's only four ingredients: cheese, butter, flour, and water.
I actually chose to use white whole wheat flour for mine. It's actually made from ground white wheat. And so it keeps more nutrients in it than all-purpose flour, which just comes from wheat flour.
I kept everything the same except my cheese. I wanted to try this mozzarella cheddar cheese just because I'm interested to see what the fat content does to the goldfish. Fat content will help like trap air better than, you know, having less fat in it. This is gonna be interesting because this is also, it says that it's fat free. So we'll see what that does to my goldfish.
7 grams.
Okay.
7 grams of total fat.
I have 6 grams of saturated fat with a total of 10 grams of fat in mine for 1 ounce.
Okay.
So, Daisy, you got 0 grams of fat in yours.
I got 0 grams of fat.
So this will be an interesting test.
Yeah, I think it won't trap the air as well. Apparently, like, fat also helps the inhibition of gluten to form. We like them because they snap. They have that snappy sound. And if we made too much gluten, we would lose that snappiness, that crack that we really like. I'm gonna predict that mine is gonna be chewy.
All right, so we're gonna add our flour.
In the recipes that we had, it didn't contain any leavening agent. So baking powder, baking soda, anything like that. And I was like, that's funny because like these crackers are puffy. In addition to wanting to just vegan substitutions to make a non-dairy cracker, so I've got some vegan cheese shreds and vegan butter. I also have some, so as I say, some different seasonings to kind of punch up the flavor a little bit.
Pulsing. So I think we're supposed to pulse it until it forms like little balls, right?
Yes.
Maybe. Is yours like really chunky together or not really?
I would describe it as sandy.
All right, I'm getting it going.
Joan, can I see what yours looks like? This is what mine looks like. Daisy, how you doing over there?
It's not good to do it in a blender.
Oh no.
So I'm putting half of it in and then the other half. So I think that should work. We thought this was going to be an easy recipe. Look at me just like turning my blender.
I really feel like I kind of have like yellow Play-Doh right now.
I'm going to flour up my surface here. All right. So all right. Goal of cracker, thin as possible, right?
Yes. Joan, is that a pasta maker?
So this is a lasagna roller, and so I'm using it to roll out the dough because I'm super lazy.
I was gonna say that's cheating.
Nope. Ah, they're so cute. All right, so crackers should not spread much, right? So I can just load this up really well.
Yeah.
What did you guys use to make your smiles?
I have like a skewer I think I can use.
I used a toothpick.
So my dough is very crumbly. I just took it out of the fridge and it's very crumbly. I mean, I can roll it out, but it's not like sticking together at all. Oh, they're so cute.
Oh my gosh, they're starting to smell, y'all. Like, not in a bad way, a good way. All right. Oof. I am thinking that these might be done. Can you tell a difference? These are unbaked thus far, and then these are the baked ones. So they definitely puffed up.
So I also put spices on mine.
Oh.
I put some onion powder, some celery flakes, and paprika.
So did you put it on right before you baked it?
No, I actually put it in the dough.
You put it in the dough, okay. All right, so when we were planning for this, we talked about the regular goldfish versus what is now the flavor blasted goldfish.
Oh, so they have like a flavor powder on them?
They have like a flavor powder. Oh. Yeah, they have a flavor powder on them, I think. So I bought this nacho cheddar popcorn seasoning.
I'm gonna try it with some of my goldfish. So I ended up pulling mine out at about 10 minutes because I noticed that there was a couple of the thin edges were turning a little bit brown, and I don't think you want them to brown too much.
Mm-hmm.
Because right now it looks actually like I'm not seeing a big difference, the puffiness between the ones with baking powder and the ones without. But they actually look really cute and they look kind of just like goldfish, so.
I also realized that we didn't talk about what happens to the protein in the cheese.
Mm-hmm.
So, because I like props.
You do, you love a good prop.
So this is my protein, right? Normally when we have a protein and we're cooking something, we unravel it. So we like destroy our protein. But when we're baking, especially with our cheese that has fat, fat is meant to also help prevent that unfolding process. So it's only gonna unfold a little bit as opposed to a lot. What color are yours, Julie?
Mine, I would say, are not a bright orange. I think, I am interested to know if yours are brighter orange because you put paprika in it.
Ah.
So, first of all, mine look remarkably like the little purchased ones. They're not quite as orange. My recipe did have a little bit of turmeric in it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So this yellow. Is the store-bought, this is the one I made. So
yours is yellow. Yours is more yellow. And also your smile is phenomenal,
Joan. It's like
Joan. Perfect. That is perfect.
Ooh. They look interesting. Let me get a GoPro. Fat content does matter. I think some of my cheese started oozing out, so they kind of looks like they have chicken pox.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Store-bought first.
Cheers. Crunchy. Good.
Yeah, so and you notice the cheese flavor coming in.
Mm-hmm.
Noticing lots of air pockets in the crunch.
Yep. Yeah.
Definitely, like you felt the crunch and then the air on the inside of it. Yep.
So are we ready to try our home-baked goldfish now?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Cheers. Okay.
Cheers.
Mmm. Okay. Mine is still crunchy.
It's crunchy. Mine doesn't have as much air pocket to it.
Mm-hmm. Same.
But it tastes good with the cheese.
Mine is very flavorful cheesy. I would say the cheese is more flavorful for me than the regular goldfish.
So the homemade ones are not quite as crispy. I don't know if I could leave them in the oven a little bit longer. And so when I try the ones with baking powder, they are very crispy.
Mm-hmm.
Because baking powder also helps bake goods crisp. So that is also one of its functions. I would say these are less cheesy than the goldfish that out of the package, but not unpleasant. And so I would say that as far as like crisp and definitely look, the ones with baking powder I find are more similar to the original goldfish, but slightly less cheesy.
Mine, I would say, is actually crispier. I opened a regular goldfish cracker and my cracker to look at the inside, and the layering is different.
Oh wow.
So this is the store-bought one, and this is the mine. I mean, you can see like sort of some pastry-ish layers to mine, but it definitely doesn't have a hole in it like the goldfish did.
Yep.
About a fifth of an inch. So mine puffed quite a bit.
Mine puffed up to about a quarter of an inch.
Oops.
If you drop. Yeah, I did go ahead and get calipers so I could measure the how much mine had puffed.
Oh, fancy.
And so I would say between 3/16 and a half of an inch. I mean, you know, depending on where and how much. So they are actually pretty puffy.
This is way better than I thought.
So I think, I mean, we've really determined this is a very adaptable recipe, right? In terms of like
absolutely.
The flour you use, the cheese you use, the butter
the
you use,
the fat content in the cheese,
the fat content of the cheese, and that you can add a bunch of different seasonings to it, which just means you can have fun and experiment in the kitchen.
Look at us!
Look at us! We did it! We can follow a recipe, adapt a recipe.
Well, thanks everyone for joining us today in the kitchen. I really enjoyed sharing this exploration of goldfish crackers.
Enjoy your snacks.
Yeah. And now snack time.
I don't know how to use the GoPro.